On a mild fall morning, the call of the seas, fresh ocean air, and the promise of adventure and intrigue called to me and my husband from the warmth of our soft futons. Where were we going? To an abandoned island. Yep, you heard that right. A abandoned island.
Well, we're ready to go. Just had a little gathering and they gave us a little safety briefing. Now we're gonna get on the boat and go. Watch your step.
The destination? Ominase, a small island just south of Katazoe. This island once served as a labor colony, military outpost, and residence in its history. It's about a 30-minute boat ride from the main island and can only be accessed by a charter boat.
We're just looking for a safe place to land. There's no docks here or anything for the boat to go next to, so we have to get creative, I guess.
なるほど。
The boat that dropped off is right over there. It's pretty amazing. He was able to just drive the boat right up onto the beach and he jumped off.
The first thing you will probably notice once you make land is, one, the dense forest opposite the beach, and two, the amount of man-made garbage laying around. Since the island is uninhabited, there is no one to care for the beach. Microplastic is a worldwide problem, and on the beaches of Ominase, you can see just how serious it really is.
It's an Inoshishi skull, wild boar.
Apparently.
Yeah, so I think we mentioned in another video that they're a little bit problematic. They're an invasive species.
But there's no Inoshishi on this island.
There's no Inoshishi on this island, so maybe this came from somewhere else.
Saru. Monkey poop.
Is there actually monkeys on this island?
Mm-hmm.
Monkey toilet.
Monkey toilet. Monkey toilet.
I thought that was just a joke.
長女が小学校上がる時にそこの学校小学校に上がった。今その方が、75ぐらい。ここに住んだ人を聞いたら風呂はですね、この辺にあったそうです。それで雨の日は入れない。それで晴れたら入れる。これで家も今の日本の、今あるような家じゃないです。 この辺の木をですね、組み立てて、こうして作った。それで私たちも、ここ家がないか探しに来たんですよ。もうやっぱり家はなかったですね。もう朽ちて、朽ち。まあ土台とかありますけど。じゃあ行きましょう。It's
quite deep, you wanna see? It's an old well.
Yeah, so this is an old well from the previous inhabitants who lived here. I can't see the bottom, so yeah, you wouldn't want to fall down that. You're not coming back up. Okay, we see some evidence of an old stove here. And, yeah, old cutlery and things. So there used to be a residence here of some sort.
ようなことで生活が苦しくなった方がここへ来られて、そうしてマホランというね、昔ロープしょったんですけど、家の前にはたくさんありますけど、それを栽培して、そしてそれを子泊まりというところの、ところの人、
が張って、そうしてそれで一応生活を立て直したらまた本州とか中央島とか、そっちの方、八代島ですかね、そっちの方へまた出るというようなことで、まあ、救済島という名前がついてる。まあそれだけじゃない、本当に住んどった方もおられますけど、もうほとんどなんかお金がいらんですよね。それでその当時靴がないから、靴は海岸に流れ着いたスリッパとか靴を履きよったから、だいたい両方が同じものは履いたことがないというふうに言われてますよね。スオオシマチャンネルの中でも役場の職員さんがちょっと、
大日本だよ。
These are glass beer bottles. This is Dai Nippon, which is it was an imperial brand, and they're not in existence anymore, I don't think.
Huh.
Yeah. So,
yeah, pretty cool.
But we came across this kind of clearing.And our tour guide is saying he doesn't really know what this area was used for, but since the rocks are kind of terraced, I'm guessing this was like maybe a farming area. Of course, these trees wouldn't have been here back in the day. Now, these are all pretty young trees.
So this is the hardest spot.
I believe it. We're going up the steepest part of the mountain right now. One of the guides brought a big box of mikan and he shared it with everyone. So of course we grabbed a couple. This is a nice thing to have when you're taking a little break. Kind of rehydrates you and it gives you a little sugar too. Anyway, they're small but they're sweet.
Very sweet.
It's always really good here.
Sure.
あそこに見えるのが小見鍋島です。それさっきお話したように。180m のこう断崖絶壁に囲まれてるから、上がる場所がですね一つしかない。左側の方に今見えませんけど灯台があるんです。あそこからしか上がれません。よくあそこは釣り人がたくさん行きます。もうどんぶかで 20m ぐらいいたら水深が 40-50m ですよね。
Was there anyone living on that island?
Nope.Nothing but cliff. There's only one spot you can go into the island.
On that one?
Yes.
Okay, so it's really unaccessible.
さっき、赤い岩に家があったって言ったでしょ。伊勢湾台風の時に、あの家が流された。それで、夜ですね、家族でこの道を通って、それで今から行く頂上に上がって、そして、私たちが降りる家の前ですか、あっちまでこう避難した。でそこにおじいさんとおばあさんが住んでおられて、まあ何軒か家あったんですけどね、そこへこう避難したって言われた。だからかなりなんか過酷な生活をされてたんじゃないかな。
今一番何層通ったの？
How are you doing?
Oh, I'm okay. I'm just getting a little hot. Because we're going uphill. Been going uphill for like the past hour. Yeah, it's just there's not really a trail. So we're kind of weaving in and out of the trees. Trying to do it as safely as possible. You can hear their barking, screeching sound. We're in a big group, so we're not in any danger of like anything happening, but they're definitely aware we're here.
because deka.
Welcome to the world of Reiki mushrooms that grow everywhere. These are comparison. So weird.
Yeah.
It's so hard. It's like when you think of a mushroom, you think it'd be like kind of spongy and soft, but these ones are. They're like.
You know how it's called in Japanese?
What is it? Oh.
Sara no koshikake.
Right, monkey seat.
Yes.
Yeah.
It really looks like monkey can sit on it.
Take it just a small break. I'm not in bad shape at all. It's normal for me to do 3 to 5 mile walking on the weekdays. But yeah, uphill is always a challenge. We're almost there though, it's fine. Well, we made it to the top of the mountain, and there's a cute little signpost here that the tour guide made. So actually the guides, they're the ones who created all of the trails and all of the signposts and any markings you see on the tree like this to even get here. So on the top of this mountain there is a very unusual war heritage. During World War II, the Japanese didn't have a radar system to spot or listen to enemy planes, but they did have an acoustic listening device, which was basically like a giant microphone. Except it didn't run on electricity, it was just this big thing that would collect sound and then you could listen in on it. And it was used to listen for any enemy planes that were flying overhead during the war. The acoustic device was taken down like years ago, but what's left is basically the base or the hitching post for where it was attached.
Okay. なるほど。
Okay, so the guide just brought us down this little, the backside of the mountain, and there is what appears to be a bunker from World War II when someone was stationed up here to use the acoustic listening device. This would have been used to house supplies, maybe a place where they could rest, or if it was raining, hide from the rain. Lunch break! Just having some hot tea and sandwiches, the group. Time to refuel. Oh, the tour guide was super nice. He actually made soup for everyone in the group.
So how is it so far?
Oh, it's really interesting. Yeah, I mean, the hiking part is not, it's not too difficult. But just kind of hearing the stories about the people who lived here, and also its war history, for me that's like, that's super interesting. You know, like kind of the things that were left behind by the people who used to live here. It's kind of sad, but well, yeah, it's kind of just a nice kind of slice of history here on the island. So far, it's really fun. We've happened upon this old brick cement building. The guide tells us that they don't know what it was for, but since it's just a few yards from the acoustic listening device, I am going to assume this is the old military barracks. It definitely looks like it, because I've seen some other of the World War II barracks in like other places, and it looks very similar to this. So, more than likely, this is the barracks.
stumbled upon something. I'm not even sure what this is. Looks like the foundation for several buildings. Just above us is a series of water tanks. So, I don't know, I'm wondering if this is like, this was like a purifying facility, or if this was like somebody's residence even. Not quite sure, but we'll go take a closer look. This is the kitchen! And you can see where they would have put the cooking pots. Would have been wood. They'd light wood under here and fire up your food. I think this is the old sink. While wandering around these ruins, I wondered if maybe this was a soldier's barracks. I wonder how many soldiers actually stayed here. And I wonder what their daily lives might have been like, living on an island that was so far away from everything. Yeah, we're just coming off the mountain. It's, of course, much more dangerous than going up, so we had to hold on the rope. Watch the footing. It's the tail end of the island.
<笑>大丈夫です。めっちゃ撮られてる。たまたま。うわ。みんな滑る。わあ、綺麗ですね、ここ。
Behind me is the remnants of an old shrine. The deity that was here was taken and it was interred at Suooshima, which is on our island. You've probably seen it in another video with the red torii gate. Some of the things that were left behind with the shrine, we have Onigawara, the guardian roof tiles of the shrine. And then, I think people are more familiar with this one. This is a Shachihoko. Which, it's supposed to be a killer whale. And these are often on the rooftops of most of the Shinto shrines that you'll see around Japan. So, it's sad that it's not here anymore, but you know, nobody lives on the island anymore, so there's no one to care for it either. Hence why they probably moved it. And combined it with ours on Suooshima. We're just making our way down the old shrine steps. These things are still here. We've just come off the mountain and we're in the old residential area where there would have been a village. During the time when people were actually living here, we've seen a lot of leftover like antique glass bottles and other kind of things that would signify people were here. fishing balls.
Is that fishing ball?
Yeah, you would use these, you'd float them in the water with the net.
Buoy.
It's an old buoy. Mom collects these. This is a real one, Mom, if you're watching this. Sorry, I can't give it to you. Keep it here. We're not allowed to keep anything that we find here, so. This is an authentic fishing buoy. Okay, so I found this little like stoneware thing and I kept thinking that this was like a lamp. But actually, it's a kotatsu. It is like the old school kotatsu. You would stick coal in it and then you would take this whole thing and stick it onto your table. Keep yourselves warm. Of course, now we have electric ones, but they do the same thing. I've never seen one of these before.
I've never seen that either.
That's so cool. On the bottom of these old bottles, there is a symbol that we've never seen before. And we were trying to figure out what it is, and we think we've got it. Basically, it's one of the symbols for the Mitsui Corporation, which is basically a conglomeration of a bunch of stuff. They make a little bit of everything.
kind of like Mitsubishi.
We just found a little signpost for the Japanese Navy.
If you look at this stone here, you see these little waves. That is the symbol for the Japanese Navy. At least during World War II, I'm not sure what it is now. But these signposts, were just to show that this was property of the Navy at the time. So if you look here, you can see the kanji for number 6, although it's very, very faint, it's there. Mm. So this was outpost number 6 of the Japanese Navy. Judging by the items and wares left behind, life must have been very challenging for the residents, but somehow they survived. There was no running water, no electricity, and no modern amenities to speak of. The old bottles with imperial emblems are an interesting window into history and is a reminder of how times change so rapidly. The island is a time capsule for life during and right after the war, so it's interesting to imagine how life must have been at that time for the residents.
This plant is mokran. It's a really fibrous, sinewy plant that would be used to make rope. And the village here, this is how they made their money. They would make rope from this plant and then they'd go to the main island, sell it on the main island. But yeah, just playing around with it. This would make really, really good baskets. You could weave it really easily into something, a basket or even like a little pouch.
It's just what's left.
It was a mofran planter.
Mofran. Used to be, but it just...
Did I say mofran?
Mofran. Mofran. Yeah. I didn't even know the word.
The boat is here to pick us up, but the sea is actually very rough right now on the side of the island, so I don't know how we're actually going to get in here. I don't know if he could actually park up on the beach like he did on the other side, so we might have to maybe walk around to a place where it's a little bit more calm for him.
Lucky for us, our captain was incredibly experienced and had no trouble coming onto the beach to pick us up.
We're gonna get wet.
Yeah.
No matter what, we're gonna get wet. The benches are all soaked.
On the way back, we were supposed to do a bit more touring on the boat. Unfortunately, the water was too rough and it was safest to return back to the harbor.
Well, we just landed and it was really fun. Yeah, I enjoyed myself. I was pretty quiet during it because I was just kind of taking everything in and really trying to listen to what the tour guide was telling us. Yeah, totally worth it. Interesting and fun. And I learned a little slice of history out of Suooshima and the surrounding areas. We got some flyers for other tours that they're doing, so I'd definitely be interested in booking another tour with them to maybe one of the other islands or a different hike or something. So very fun tour. I highly recommend it. So if anyone is interested in doing like what we did and booking a tour on the charter vessel and having a guide take you out to one of the islands, we will put the info, of course, in the information section of the video. Excuse me. What is that called?
Description.
Okay, I can't think right now. I need a coffee. We will put the info in the description section. The tour guide does not speak any English, though, so it behooves you to know some Japanese or bring someone with you who can translate for you.
Hire me.
Yeah, like my husband. You can hire my husband, too. He'd totally do it. He'd go back in a heartbeat. So that is the end of this video. If you enjoyed what you saw, please do hit the like button and subscribe to us. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave those below. And we'll see you on the next video or our next adventure. I am the American Waifu. This is my Oshima Laifu. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you soon.